This is Bass Checkers. Jesus, it doesn't load.
What's up, Tomorrowland? Clap, clap, clap your hands, clap, clap. This is Bass Checker. Everybody hands up high. Put them up, put them up, put them up. What's up, Tomorrowland? Clap, clap, clap your hands, clap, clap. This is Bass Checker.
What's up, Tomorrowland? Clap, clap, clap your hands. Clap, clap. Let's go. This is Bass Checker.
Put your hands up, put your fucking hands up, put your hands up, put your fucking hands up. Here we go.
from the front to the back, hands up high.
Jump! What's up, Tomorrowland? Clap, clap, clap your hands, clap, clap. Let's go. This is Bass Checkers.
Losing all my innocence, everybody in my mind. I didn't know my innocence, everybody in my mind. Losing all my innocence, everybody in my mind. But yeah, those guys absolutely killed it. You know, you killed it when Catherine walks in and it's like, holy shit! Like, you know, she's...
Is that what she said?
I mean, oh, she's something to that effect, yeah.
Damn.
Hold on one second. Dude. I want to see if I can get up in the gamers hub too.
I just thought it was cool how like the lights actually sync to the music and stuff. I mean, that was like I think I put in Discord how Anorex, like right when you open that door, it's like literally hits you in the face. You're like, holy shit, this feels real. Like this is real.
Yeah. Did anyone else notice the pyrotechnics too?
Oh, they had everything popping, yo. They had it popping.
Like, dude, the only thing missing are like actual bottles that you could purchase and like. Dude,
I wouldn't be surprised if that's what's coming up next. Like, those dudes was like, that was so killer. And then they got the shit for rent. I want to definitely, I mean, obviously, I'm interested in doing a show there of some sort or some shit like that. Like, that shit was sick, yo.
Imagine an emote of popping a bottle and, like, spraying it on everybody.
Yo, the emote, we haven't even scratched the surface with emotes, man. For real. Like, so much that needs to be and can be done with emotes is going to be wild, yo. That was like, I don't know, like really inspiring, actually, like that whole event there and everything today. Because the I don't know if you guys got a chance to go to the Norn Origin thing. Norn Origin was sick. DCL, like the Decentraland song was playing. Everything just kind of like was real dope today.
Yeah,
it was real cool.
I spent like 6 hours in that Axie tournament. It drug on forever. I didn't get a chance to go to the Norn Origin stuff.
Yo, I would have, man.
Hours.
That
was crazy.
That was ridiculous. That was, and I don't want to get trashing nobody's shit. So, but it was a little bit lengthy. You know what I mean?
It just takes so. There's 45 people. And not to digress too much from the conversation, but there's 45 people. It just takes forever to get everyone like synced into the matchups and stuff. But, but yeah. Anyway, awesome weekend in the metaverse and everything else. All the art week stuff that's been going on, and then the club today. It was like a nice extra boost to have like a different event on a Saturday and not just rely on like Friday night stuff to carry us for the week.
Right.
So what I want to say, cool. Frankie, is I watched you and GG do that whole commentary on the Axies.
Yeah.
Morning. I think it was like a day ago you did it, but
yeah.
I got a chance to watch you guys, and I was like, it was cool. Like, I normally can't stand a match like that, you know, like those, but you guys make it fun, dude. So yeah. I just wanted to give you props on that. It's
good
cool.
Good luck.
Like,
appreciate you, man.
Interesting.
Yeah, man. That's another thing that we had going on this week. We had the Crypt Fest mini tournament or whatever, mini battle on Thursday. Actually, because it was funny, that day was another, like, very busy day. And I had like that, and then I got, like, Ball sent me a, he let me know, whoa. He let me know that the article came out from CoinDesk, and Jeff had mentioned me in the article. So I after that, I was checking that out. Like, that was dope. There was like several things that happened that day, and at the end of the night, I was talking with Drew from MetaFactory about some things. So it was just a really cool day too. You know what I'm saying? So there's a lot going on, man. Everybody's kind of like really. I think people are starting to recognize that there's a whole new like, I don't know, new vigor. To DCL, you know what I'm saying? Like, we're really, you know, getting it going, you know what I mean? So it's
yeah,
awesome.
Yeah, man, it was like only 2 months ago where we could count like in a fist, like how many events are going to be happening within that week. But now it's like too many things are happening that we're actually missing stuff.
It's great. So mm-hmm.
There's too many places to be, too many things to like to do.
Yeah.
And then there's the news channel, yeah, man.
That's talk the most to him, talk to him open. Yep.
Damn. And so let's talk about that that article from CoinDesk. So that was in the making for like, I don't know, it feels like a month or two.
And the article from CoinDesk. Oh yeah, that was super cool, man.
It felt like they forgot about us, like, because we did the interview and then it was like silence for at least a month, and then they just dropped it. So yeah, it was a good article. It was good for Decentraland overall. I think you did a good job kind of capturing the atmosphere of Decentraland at the moment, like how it feels like it's empty, but you know, if you go at the right times, it's like there's stuff happening.
And
on top of that, all the creators, you know, so overall it was really positive.
Yeah,
it was a really good read. I thought it was really interesting, and they had a little humor in it also, so it's kind of cool.
Yeah, it was sick talking to him. I think that dude, we were just going and going, and I was like, he's like, yeah, I got things to do, you know. Like, I'm like, I get it, man. I'm not mad at you, man. I could have talked to that dude all night. He's cool as hell, man. For real.
Yeah.
Yeah, CoinDesk is like a really big thing, right? Like, that's like the biggest crypto media entity, isn't it?
I think
it's like the equivalent of being like on, you know, like on a Forbes article if you're like in investing in like, you know, traditional equities, I'm assuming, right?
Yeah.
Which is pretty cool.
Yeah.
Did anybody notice like any kind of like, because everyone got a pretty decent plug, you know, did anybody notice like some kind of increase in whatever the fucks, like Twitter follows or?
I mean, for me, it's just a great reference, you know what I'm saying? Like, I know that I can always use that as a reference, you know, like.
Oh yeah, in this, like, you know? Drop the link. He's like, this is who I am.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So I was on that CoinDesk article.
It was a good look, man. It's never a bad look to be in something like that, you know. So it was great.
Hopefully, they keep writing more.
Yeah.
Is that guy like in charge of like covering metaverse topics, or he just? I don't know anything about the.
I think he was in charge of that article. I don't think he was necessarily in charge. He was very interested. That's for sure. He was like definitely interested in what was going on. But I don't know that he's like necessarily just in charge of it or not, whatever. So,
yeah, because I went to their Twitter, dude. They post like 20 things a day or something
exactly,
like that.
Exactly. Yeah, like, they were like, it was already like kind of down the list when it came out.
Yeah,
that's insane.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they must have a lot of journalists in that, you know, working for that company. It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
That's a good start, though. I mean, it puts some weight on the belt. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah, it definitely put it in a conversation with like larger projects, in my opinion, you know. Like, a lot of people don't know exactly what's up with Decentraland. And, you know, when I first found Decentraland, it was a coin to me. So, you know, if you're looking at it like on an exchange and it's a coin, so you're just like, that coin has a world? You know, that world has people? And those people are real? You know, it's like, that's, you know, that's some mind-blowing shit to you as a investor. You know what I'm saying?
And it feels more tangible, too, just because since we have an open world associated with a coin, you go to any other, like, crypto project, it just doesn't feel the same. It doesn't feel tangible. It doesn't feel like there's any use to a coin. Like, why use their coin versus Ethereum? Like, why just generate a new coin for something like this? I mean... But it makes more sense for Decentraland just because people have their own little economy, right? There's an economy forming, and there's a coin that represents that economy, and everybody's collective effort is to grow the value.